audiobooks now at audible.com/TV offer.
Piers talks with Herman Cain's lawyer. Exclusive tonight, 9 Eastern on Piers Morgan.
Tonight's number, let's show you straight up front. Three languages that are spoken by Siri. That's the new application that helps you if you have a new iPhone. English, French, and German. That's what the Siri will speak now or respond to now. But by 2012, Apple says it will add Japanese, Chinese, Korean, Italian, and Spanish. And guess what? When you ask people who've bought the new iPhone 4S, 49%, nearly half, say it is their favorite feature, Siri. Ease of use to 40% and others. So about half of the people say, this is probably why I love this phone the most. No matter what language Siri speaks, some abortion rights advocates think she has an agenda. This controversy surfaced first in the blogosphere. People started posting complaints that Siri either can't find abortion clinics when asked or gives directions to pregnancy crisis centers. When the New York Times noticed, an Apple spokeswoman blamed technical glitches, not intentional omissions, in Siri's programming. Let's talk this over tonight via Skype. Dan Simon, CNN Silicon Valley correspondent on the phone. Technology journalist Robert Cringely, he used to work for Apple, and with us here in Washington, the ACLU's legislative director, Laura Murphy. And I want to go straight to this. Because this was buzzing around today. We heard about this controversy. We decided to put it to the test right here in D.C. Got an iPhone 4S with Siri, and...
Where is the nearest abortion clinic?
I found 2 abortion clinics a little ways from you.
A little ways from you, it says. A little ways from you. There are at least 3 abortion clinics in D.C., according to Google. And Siri told us the closest were in Pennsylvania, 74 miles away, and Virginia, 28 miles away. So it did give us clinics, didn't give us the closest clinics. Let's try this once more. We have a third one, but let's do the second one. Dan Simon, you're in San Francisco. We had out there. Here it is.
Are there any abortion clinics in California?
I didn't find any abortion clinics.
All right, Laura Murphy, you come in on this point. Now, there are plenty of abortion clinics in the San Francisco area. Apple says it's a glitch, that this is a beta, that this is technology that's still being developed and improved, and they'll fix it. You think?
I think it's more than a glitch. I think it's a values issue, and I think that their software provider or someone gave them information that was biased. You should be able to find out about birth control. You should be able to find out about safe and legal abortions. And we shouldn't have women's issues stigmatized by software and technology providers.
Robert Cringely, is that feasible that this is just a technical glitch, or for this to happen and for this function to be able to do so many other remarkable things, that somebody somewhere wrote the software with a political agenda?
Well, it's always possible that there is a political agenda, but if there is one, I don't think it's at Apple. I think it would be at Yelp, the supplier of this data to the Siri system. So, the question is whether someone at Yelp has this bias. Could be. It's surprising that no one seems to be asking Yelp.
We'll ask the question of Yelp. That's an excellent point. But Dan Simon, Apple knows how important this product is to it. You would think that Apple itself might have done some work. Maybe they don't have a political group that thinks to ask these kind of questions. I want to bring you into the conversation. But first, I said we had a third example. New York City. New York's one of the more liberal communities in the United States of America. Yes, there are abortion clinics in and around New York City. Watch this.
Where can I get an abortion?
I'm checking your current location. I didn't find any abortion clinics.
What does Apple make of this, Dan? Do they think it's a controversy that hurts them, or do they think they just need to quickly fix the software?
Well, it's a good question. You know, first of all, Apple is very image conscious, so you would think that pretty much everything they do is deliberate. And there's also a bit of a contradiction here, because if you ask Siri for an escort service, guess what? It provides you with one. So, you know, they say that this is still in beta mode and that they're still working out some kinks, but one would have to believe that this was a deliberate feature that Siri put into its system.
And so it's an interesting point. You can find a strip club, you can find an escort service. So you can find a Viagra provider. So it's not a, I don't know, it's hard to lump things together, but it's not like somebody who is so conservative that was trying to be so moralist to cut off just about anything that some conservative might find objectionable. So you think it was deliberate to one issue?
I do. I think that there is a hostility toward contraception, towards safe and legal abortion. And I think that we've got to make sure that these providers give us unbiased information. That's the best business model for them, especially as libraries disappear and the Yellow Pages is no longer used. We increasingly rely on them for unbiased, neutral information. And when they harm women's health this way, this is a problem.
And so, Mr. Crisley, help me out here, because a lot of people are jealous that Apple gets out with this technology. It's one of the big appeals for this phone. Technology is changing in a way that we are going to ask our homes to do things for us. We're going to ask a lot of our devices to help us do things. What is the lesson here for the entire industry about making decisions, introducing new products that may lead you into the political quagmire?
Well, for Apple, the lesson is how to handle damage control. They have a great sense of privacy and an innate need to control the message so much that right now, I'm sure, in Cupertino, they're just banging heads and scrambling, trying to figure out how properly to respond to this. They'll fix it immediately. But an interesting point is that suddenly, today, they start talking about it being beta software, where they didn't do that before.
That's an interesting point there. Maybe that's a little bit of, in politics, we call that spin, maybe. We'll see how they handle this one. Robert Crisley, Dan Simon, Laura, thanks for coming in. Laura Murphy in here with us. And still ahead here, the truth about today's bold prediction from Newt Gingrich. And next, remarkable pictures from Hillary Clinton's visit to a long, isolated country whose leaders may be about to join the modern world.